Good morning, I'm Cicely Mathenia.
And I'm Tyler Wilkie. Today is Tuesday, April 17th, and here are today's top stories and announcements. There are new AR tests in the library. They include Edumacation of Jay Baker by Jay Clark, Infamous Chronicles of Nick by Sherilyn Kenyon, Tankborn by Karen Sandler, Nick Night She Disappeared by April Henney. There is also Life Eternal, A Dead Beautiful Novel by Yvonne Wood, Anna Dressed in Blood by Kendra Blake, Space Between by Brenna Yovanoff, Spellbound by Rachel Hawkins, and finally Hollowed by Cynthia Hand. Also, join the high school summer reading program at THS during summer school. You can earn fall AR points and a half elective credit. Choose from reading groups like Gateway, World War II, Nonfiction, High-Low, Required Reading, and Nonfiction Fiction. You will have the opportunity to Skype with authors, create book trailers, debate conversational topics, journal online, and more. Interested? Sign up today.
Fashion One students that created shoes for the Relay for Life and Cancer Research in Ms. Zarillo's class, please stop by and pick up your shoe if it has not already been delivered to you. After Friday, if you have not picked it up, they will be donated to another Relay group to use. Thank you again for helping us stomp out cancer. The winner of the competition goes to Brianna Bolger, putting a stop to cancer. Please stop by and receive your prize. Second place goes to Adriana Yanez, Hunt for a Cure, and third to Ashley Stoll, Secure the Memories. Great work, fashion classes. Also, congratulations to Damon Brown for being a national qualifier in extemporaneous speaking. He will compete in the Tournament of Champions at the Northwestern University of Chicago, May 11th through the 13th.
It's National Student Leadership Week. Part of being a great leader is being prepared, especially for college. It's closer than you think. Seniors, are you ready for college? Make sure you have completed your FAFSA, applied for housing, and signed up for orientation. It'll be here in no time. Juniors, be sure to register for the ACT, research your college options, and be ready to apply for college in the fall. Senior year goes by faster than you think. Students have the opportunity to do their part for their local hospital patients at the next community center blood drive, held in the small gym on Wednesday, May 2nd from 8 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. To make an appointment, sign up at lunch with Abby Relihand or email Angie Zarillo. April showers bring May flowers, so that is why the item of the month is umbrellas.
Now we'll look at your weather with Shay Davis.
Okay, so it's looking a little warmer out there. At 46 degrees right now, and later today it's going to get up to 74. And then for tonight it's going to be 53 degrees and partly cloudy, so tomorrow it's going to be 76 degrees, partly sunny and breezy, so it is going to be warmer for the rest of the week. So coming up with our 5-day forecast, it's going to be 70, 73, 59, but on Thursday there is a chance of storms, so watch out for that. And there is also a chance of storms on Friday, so make sure to bring your umbrellas those days. So back to you guys.
Applications for KTSN TV 15 News are now available in room 244. Anyone interested in auditioning will need to submit the application by Friday, April 20th. Auditions will be Wednesday, April 25th from 2:30 to 5. See Mr. Merrithew for any questions or audition schedule conflicts. This Wednesday, April 18th, will be the last meeting of the school year for the CIA. We will be having a picnic theme, and RSVPs are requested by today with Mrs. Downs. The meeting starts at 2:30 and ends by 4, at a cost of $2. The board will meet on Tuesday after school to discuss our exciting end-of-the-year project.
If you are in need of a tutor, you must sign up for one no later than April 25th. The closer we get to finals, the more difficult it becomes to find an eligible person. If you have any questions or would like to sign up for a tutor, please see Mrs. Dendish in the Counseling Center. Seniors, the scholarship deadline for MCC has been extended until April 30th. Please see the MCC website for further information. The District 14 Scholars Bowl finals were an all-independence affair with Truman facing William Chrisman. The Patriots edged the Bears in a contest that was tied at halftime. In addition, the four top scorers in the district tournament were from Independence, with Andy Muehlman taking the top honors.
Please mark your calendar for the last Special Olympics event of this year. On April 28th, the athletes will compete at the track and field competition at Lee's Summit North. This is one of the largest events in the area, and the kids appreciate your support both there and your encouragement leading up to and following the event. Thank you for being so positive about their efforts. Also, Spread the Word t-shirts will be available to order in the Patriot Cup for $12 each. Orders must be placed by April 20th, and proceeds will go to the Special Olympics of Missouri and your Truman Special Olympics team.
In sports, girls soccer lost 2-0 against Blue Springs, but are hoping to bounce back against Lee Summit West today. In tennis, last Saturday, Truman took third place as a team at the Truman Tennis Tournament. Five of the six Truman players received individual medals. Getting second place in B-flight singles was Zach Fells. Taking second place in A-flight doubles were Matt Perry and David Franklin. In B-flight doubles, Brett Fredenberg and freshman Sam Haycock took third place. Also, varsity tennis won 8-1 yesterday against Lee Summit. Winners for Truman and singles were Mason Short, David Franklin, Zach Fell, Brett Fredenberg, and Andy Muehlman. Double victories were recorded by Matt Perry and David Franklin, Mason Short and Zach Fells, Brett Fredenberg, and Andy Muehlman. In baseball, the Patriots won over Belton 9-3 in the first round of the Eastern Jackson County Tournament. They play again today at Legacy Park. Attention wrestlers, there will be a mat time on Mondays and Wednesdays at 3:15 p.m. Please lift first and then report to the wrestling room. See Coach Goes if you have any questions. This is also a reminder that there will be baseball games every day this week after school, and it is suggested all cars be moved away from the baseball field so they are not hit by foul balls.
Today for lunch, we are having a fajita Santa Fe salad with baked scoops and a chicken salad bar.
And on the grill line, we have a barbecue sandwich with nacho Doritos or a barbecue turkey sandwich with baked spicy fries.
For the latest school headlines, visit THS Media Online. Click on the KTSN TV15 news link to see a rebroadcast of the daily morning announcements. You can follow us on Twitter by texting 40404 and type follow at THS News Media. Log on to Facebook and like us. And you can view the morning news and Patriot Vision at youtube.com/THSNewsMedia. Click the subscribe button and stay informed on the go.
We would like to wish a happy Poplin. If you would like your birthday announced or other announcements, please email Mr. Merrithew the day before by 3:20. Include Kathy Glasgow on general announcement emails. Any emails sent after this time will not be included the next day. In the email, please list the dates you would like your message to appear on the morning news.
It looks like landlines could be a part of history. Indiana and Wisconsin are considering laws to end the requirement of providing everyone with landlines.
According to a report in USA Today, Alabama, Kentucky, and Ohio are also considering deregulating the phone service. Companies like AT&T say that this will increase competition in the wireless industry, as well as increase investment in better technology instead of expanding the dying landline industry.
As of June 2011, 32% of U.S. households were wireless only, up from 10.5% in 2006.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Patriots.
Have a great Tuesday.